My name is Clarice Barton. After the sudden death of my husband, my son and I moved to a quiet seaside town called Tideville. It was going to be a fresh start for us, and for a while, we were happy. But one peaceful autumn evening, everything changed. Just the night before, I had a dream that filled me with the most disturbing sense of dread. Perhaps I should have seen it all coming. Hi, Rudy. Where's Tim? I thought you two were spending the day together.
I haven't seen him all day, Mrs. Barton. He wouldn't open the door for me. There's a strange blue glow coming from Tim's room. I didn't know what to do, so I waited for you to come home. I'm sorry.
You did the right thing, Rudy. I'm going to go check on Tim. Stay here until I can find out what's going on.
Okay, Mrs. Barton.
Tim, what's going on?
Help me, Mom! Collect the blue crystals! And hurry! I don't have much time, Mom. The scientist, he took me. He wants me to help him build his machine. Please, hurry!
Something strange is going on, Rudy. Tim's gone. He was holding a strange glowing device, and then he just vanished. Did he tell you anything about a new machine he was building?
He's always talking about building things. He did say something yesterday about having to save someone. I thought he was just joking around.
Thank you, Rudy. In Tim's diary, there are drawings of a building and some kind of mechanism. But part of the page has been torn out. Do you know anything about this?
Oh, yeah. Tim gave me a piece of paper a few days ago. I bet it's the diary page. I left it somewhere in my room. I'll follow you down the street to my house. The front door is a little hard to open. Here's a hint. Gosh, Mrs. Barton, I can't find that paper Tim gave me. I know it's around here somewhere.
Thank you.
found the diary page. I hope it helps you find Tim, Mrs. Barton.
Me too, Rudy, but I'm afraid I won't be able to look very far. One of those mechanical creatures has blocked my way to the square.
Be careful around those things. Whenever they show up, people in town disappear. Tim was working on a machine that could scare them off. He came in here to make it because he didn't want to bother you with the noise. It's on my desk, but some of the parts are missing. Maybe you could use the blueprint to put it together.
You boys sure got up to a lot while I wasn't looking. I'll try to find the missing parts. I think I've done it. I guess all I have to do now is turn it on near the monster and wait.
Great job, Mrs. Barton. Hey, take this. Tim gave it to me. He said it was a clue for something. I wasn't really listening, but it might help.
Thank you, Rudy.
Thank you. Hello, Miss...
Mrs. Barton, sir. Clarice Barton.
Ah, I am Mr. Wilson. What can I do for you?
My son Tim has disappeared. I saw a number of old reports about other missing people on the bulletin board near my house. I haven't lived here long, but I thought you might have some information about the disappearances.
Perhaps, perhaps, but my memory isn't quite as sharp as it used to be. Could you show me one of the reports?
Of course. Here's one of the old newspapers.
Oh dear. I'm afraid my vision isn't as sharp as it used to be. Now, where did I put my glasses? Would you mind helping me look for them?
Of course not. I'd be happy to help.
Ah, thank you, my dear.
Yes, sir. He disappeared under very unusual circumstances.
How dreadful. The disappearances began years ago. People were afraid, and they eventually turned the blame on a scientist who had once lived in our town. He was a brilliant inventor who created many amazing devices, including mechanical creatures. One of his creatures, a spider, was not well received by residents. They feared it might be dangerous. When the spider malfunctioned at an exhibition, the scientist's fate was sealed. He was driven out of town.
Tim did say something about a scientist. Does anybody know where the scientist went or where he is now?
I only know that he left town. It was rumored that he literally vanished into thin air. But I don't put much stock in rumors. Perhaps you could talk with someone else in town. Oh, I did hear one thing. The pub owner, Mr. Miller, was boasting about a strange object he had found. He claimed it was related to the scientist.
Thank you very much, Mr. Wilson. This was quite helpful. Mr. Miller, my name is Clarice Barton. I really need your help. I'm looking for information.
Everyone is always asking for help, but does anyone ever ask if I need help? No.
All right. What can I help you with?
My grandfather owned the old bell tower. You know the one. He had a medallion, a family heirloom of sorts, but he forgot where he put it. Old age, you see. All I have is an old photo of the medallion. If you track it down, I'll give you whatever information you want.
All right, Mr. Miller. I'll find your grandfather's medallion.
Did you find the medallion?
I'll bring it to you.
Did you find the medallion?
I'll bring it to you.
Your son belongs to me now. Don't even try to find him.
This is it. I know I talk a mean talk, but my grandfather was a great man, and this medallion will keep him close to my heart. Thank you. Now, what do you want to know?
My son is missing. I think he was taken by the scientist who used to live in this town. Mr. Wilson at the library said you had some object related to him. Can I see it?
Your son is missing. Well, why didn't you say so? Sure, I can show you. I found it on the ground after one of those mechanical monsters disappeared. In fact, I'll not only show it to you, I'll give it to you. It's not doing me any good. All of the machines popping up in town were created by that scientist. Some say what he's really working on is a huge machine powered by people's brains. But no one knows the truth. People think he's hiding on the abandoned island. Maybe you should talk to Mr. Barrow, the ferryman, about all this. His house is down by the docks.
Thank you, Mr. Miller.
He's using dreams to complete his machine. Be careful, Mom. He won't let you stand in his way.
fool, you may try, but you will not ruin my plans. I will finish my machine, and I will destroy this wicked world.
I apologize for barging in, Mr. Barrow, but I desperately need your help.
I'm listening.
My name is Clarice Barton. My son, Tim, has been kidnapped. But it's not the first abduction to happen in this town. There are rumors that a scientist is behind all of them. Do you know anything about this?
No one believes me, but I know the truth. That madman is on the abandoned island as we speak. I've seen a glow coming from there at night. I'd let you see for yourself, but I gave my old telescope to Mr. Wilson at the library.
Thank you, Mr. Barrow.
Thank you.
Hello, Clarice. Were you able to find any useful information?
Yes, I was. Mr. Barrow thinks the scientist is living on the abandoned island. He's seen strange lights. I must take a closer look.
I believe I have Mr. Barrow's old telescope. The bell tower would be an ideal vantage point. It's the tallest building in town. Unfortunately, I haven't the slightest idea where I put that telescope. But feel free to look around.
Thank you, Mr. Wilson.
Your son would be a worthy assistant. He's a very intelligent boy. You should be proud, but you will never see him again.
Thank you.
Tim. Oh, Tim!
Mom, you need to get to the abandoned island. You will find me there. Hurry!
Mr. Barrow, I must get to that island. Can you take me?
I suppose I could take you, but my old ferry has been out of commission for years. To prepare for the trip, I need my logbook, navigation maps, and a map of the island, a compass, and some coal. That's a lot of things.
I'll find them, Mr. Barrow. I have to reach that island. But where should I start looking?
My logbook would be somewhere here in the house, I suppose. I kept my navigation maps in the old bell tower. I don't know why. The library must have a map of the island. As for the rest, I can't help you. Oh, but you can take this key. You'll need it to find the map of the island. Also, this mechanical thing I found might help somehow. It looks like a part from one of those mechanical creatures.
Thank you. I'll find everything.
Good, but you'll need all the things I mentioned.
Thank you.
I need a map of the abandoned island. Mr. Barrel said there would be one here.
Well, I think the only place it can be is the hiding place on top of the bookshelf. I've never been able to open it, but I have one of the keys.
Thank you again.
Do you have all the things I told you about? We can't set out to sea without them.
I'll find them.
Good, but you'll need all the things I mentioned. Good, but you'll need all the things I mentioned. Good, but you'll need all the things I mentioned. I'll take you to that cursed island, but I'm not setting a single toe on shore.
That's fine.
So you did manage to make it here, did you? But you will never leave this island. Your efforts are starting to annoy me. Forget your son and stop interfering with my plans.
Mom, you need to get to the yard of the abandoned orphanage.
Stop trying to help her. It's pointless. She's going to disappear soon.
Thank you.
Be careful, Mom. You're in terrible danger here. Find the secret room with the portal to set me free.
She is doomed, doomed, and she will be trapped for all eternity.
Thank you.
Gone too far, but I will never let you find your son. You won't pass here. Don't even try it.
I was in this room. You're so close to setting me free. Hurry!
No. Oh, I don't like this. Don't you dare interfere with my plans. Clarice!
him. Oh, Tim, my son. I was so worried I would never see you again. And so I was finally reunited with my son. But this was not the end of my story.